A little longer before NASA astronauts return to the moon. Today, the agency announced the next two missions for the Artemis program are being pushed back.
West 2 Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heidler explains the reason for the delays.
We still have a long... The news coming from NASA Administrator Bill Nelson on Tuesday. Schedules sliding as safety is paramount and critical spacecraft and testing not coming at a pace initially expected.
And to give Artemis teams more time to work through the challenges with first-time developments, operations, and integration, we're going to give more time on Artemis 2 and 3.
So that means a full 2 years between NASA's Artemis first and second missions, the program to bring humans back to the lunar surface, paving the way for Mars exploration. Artemis 2 was slated to carry astronauts around the moon in November this year, now pushed back to September 2025.
Splashdown.
Artemis 1 splashed down December 2022, an uncrewed test mission for the SLS rocket stack and the Orion spacecraft that'll carry those humans back to the moon after more than 50 years.
They found things that they didn't expect and encountered additional issues such as the heat shield and then problems that they found with the batteries.
For Artemis 3, the first human footprints in moon dust since 1972, now pushed to September 2026. The big challenge here, SpaceX's Starship that will be the lunar lander, and it's still in the testing phase.
And with everyone relying sort of on Starship as the next generation space vehicle, any issues will kind of filter down to all of the programs that are involved with that, with the ability to use that Starship vehicle.
NASA leadership and commercial partners also on that teleconference expressing confidence in this new timeline, saying that each mission will build on the previous one from data gathered and lessons learned.
So I'm sure everybody has a vested interest in trying to move as quickly, but of course also as safely as possible, especially when we have humans involved.
On the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.